Hey guys, Michelle here from ergonomictrends.com, and today I'm going to be looking at the Sedis T50 office chair. The Sedis costs around a third of a comparable Herman Miller, and yet it has many of the same features. But can a price slash of that much still equal a comfortable and ergonomic chair? Having been purchased over 1.6 million times worldwide from 2008 until 2018, it seems the answer is yes. I put it to the test. Assembly of the chair was reasonably easy, with very few steps to get through. The only difficult step was to attach the backrest to the seat pan, which required more force than expected. This was a little difficult to control when supporting the weight of the fairly heavy seat pan. Anyone advised not to lift heavy objects should get someone to help them assemble the chair. The seat width measures 18.5 inches, which should provide ample room for most users. You're looking at around 2 inches of padding for your backside. It's still comfortable, but if you're looking for a plush seat, this is not it. The seat height range is very generous and goes lower than in most office chairs. The seat depth adjusts so you can get that perfect 1 to 2 inch distance between the cushion and your knee joint to alleviate pressure from the thighs, which is also helped by the waterfall seat. Another feature that assists with pressure control is the forward seat tilt. It is used when dealing with forward-leaning tasks, such as working on a low table. I hadn't realized how much I was tensing my neck, waist, and back until I tried it and felt immediate relief in those areas. The backrest has good tilt adjustability with 5 lockable angles. These proved useful to change depending on what activity I was doing, whether I wanted to tilt back and relax to watch a film or sit upright to type. The lumbar support has 2 types of adjustability. You can move it up or down. You can also move it in or out, towards or away from your back using a lever at the top of the support. I kept it on the lowest setting, as I found that although it does have a cushion, the increased pressure felt uncomfortable and hit hard against my spine. The armrests benefit from 3-way adjustability: up, down, left, right, and in, out. I found them very easy to use and appreciated the notches on the height adjustment that helped me make sure that I was matching both sides. The TN50 model that I was testing does not come with a headrest, but one can be purchased separately as it does have the fixture needed to attach it. On the whole, the T50 is quite comfortable. The mesh backrest kept my back nice and cool, whilst the fabric cushion kept my thighs and backside warm. The one big issue I found with the chair is that it rolls almost uncontrollably on hard surfaces. I have slightly uneven flooring in my office and found myself drifting towards the other side of the room. This is a chair in definite need of a robust floor mat if being used on a hard floor. On the other hand, it glides beautifully across carpet, without any unwanted movement occurring when at a desk. The Sedis T50 boasts a Green Guard certification, meaning that eco-friendly, non-toxic materials were used in the build. It is also advertised as having been through rigorous quality tests conducted by BIFMA in the United States. Both of these things certainly give the chair a good image as well as a confidence boost to a potential buyer who is considering the chair. And it not only looks good on paper, but in practice. It has an attractive white and grey colour scheme and a build quality that doesn't look or feel cheap or rough, despite being predominantly plastic. Overall, I think the Sedis T50 lives up to its reputation. It is a solid office chair that boasts many ergonomic features, as well as multiple adjustability options that will help each user fit the chair to their needs. I would recommend it for people looking to invest a bit more money in improving their office health without breaking the bank. Follow the link in the description to read the full review of this chair on ergonomictrends.com, where you can also browse other chair reviews, as well as find articles and guides on how to improve your office health and ergonomics.